Now we're going to experiment four. Experiment four is the envelope experiment. I have a subtitle of that called a Schrodinger cat investigation. This is an experiment that I talked about. I used it as a teaching tool in many of my talks where I was doing workshops, where I'd talk about the whole of MBT, and a part of it was about science, and during that part, to explain what delayed eraser meant, I did this delayed eraser experiment, kind of a thought experiment, and I did it with envelopes. And I ran an experiment, just like you see here, where the detector 1 and 2 are on, both recorders are on, so we're going to get which way information. So we're going to end up with a particle pattern, two bars, and I'm going to run this, let's say, just make up numbers, I'm going to run this, say, 20 times. And if I run this 20 times, I'm going to take this data out on R1, R2, and R3 on thumb drives or little flash drives, portable flash drives. So I'll have all the data, what's in R1, what's in R2, and what's on R3 on flash drives. And then I'm going to do the next experiment, and I'm going to take that data out on flash drives. Well, we know that all these flash drives should have the same thing on them. I'm just repeating the same experiment over and over again, taking data out on new flash drives. So I'll eventually have 20 sets of flash drives, an R1, an R2, and an R3. Three flash drives, a little group of three, and I'll have 20 of those groups of three for each of the experiment. But yet nobody has looked at any of the data. So the data is still unknown. Now, what we're going to try to do here is see whether a macro level eraser, delayed eraser, works as well as the micro level eraser, or whether there's something different about this experiment being done at the macro level and being done in this way. So after we have this 20 groups of three, we're going to randomly take 10 of those groups of three and destroy the R1, R2 data. And that's destroy those flash drives. We're going to take the flash drives and we're going to burn them until there's nothing but liquid and ash. No possibility of any data ever being retrieved from them. Well, that's our erasure. We've just erased the which way data on 10 of the 20 experiments that we have done. And then we're going to look at all the result screen data from the R3 that was collected. And what we would hope to find would be that for all the experiments where the which way data was destroyed before anybody saw any of the results, we'll end up with a diffraction pattern. And on those experiments where the which way data was not destroyed, we'll end up with a two-bar pattern. So that one's up for grabs. We'll see how it comes out when we do it.